DCIS is the abbreviation for ductal carcinoma in situ. Ductal carcinoma in situ is the earliest form of breast cancer, where the abnormal cells are confined to the milk duct of the breast. So by definition, they have no ability to spread anywhere in the body or go anywhere because they are dependent on the milk duct. Now, we also call this stage zero breast cancer sometimes, or even maybe pre-cancer. But the real important point is that duct carcinoma in situ is highly treatable, highly curable, and we have many treatment options for patients with DCIS.
Yeah, I mean, like you said, when I talk to my patients about it, I'll tell them, you're going to hear this called any number of things, DCIS, pre-cancer, non-invasive cancer, stage zero cancer. And to your point, I always emphasize to patients that this is it's kind of a speed bump on your road of life, but it's not a threat to your mortality. So the majority of women diagnosed with DCIS have that diagnosis made after having had an abnormal mammogram. So in fact, that's why we saw such a bump in the number of cases of DCIS that were diagnosed once screening mammogram became routinely performed. It's pretty uncommon at this point to have a patient present with DCIS with an actual symptom such as a mass or pain or something of that sort.
Yeah, absolutely. But it is important still to be aware of changes in the breast. If a woman were to notice some fluid from the nipple, for example, we call that nipple discharge. That can also be an early sign of cancer, again, most commonly DCIS. So certainly we want women to bring those symptoms to their provider's attention. But as Dr. Mittendorf mentioned, screening mammography really has been the standard, the most common way to find DCIS. So the treatment of DCIS generally includes some combination of surgery, potentially radiation therapy, and then potentially medication in the form of endocrine therapy. Surgery has really been the mainstay of treatment for DCIS for decades, although there are efforts now to identify patients with perhaps such low-grade DCIS that maybe they don't need any treatment. But right now, we still counsel women on the role of surgery to remove the abnormal cells, the milk ducts containing the abnormal cells. And then we talk about the other treatments, radiation and medical treatment, as ways to decrease the risk of recurrence of their DCIS. And so these are very individualized treatment choices. We really aim to try to help women understand what their risks are and really try to define the best combination of treatments for each individual.
Yeah, I think that's such an important point. DCIS is something where we really can personalize the treatment, not only based on the diagnosis that they have, but their preferences. And so, as you know, we spend a lot of time on this journey with the patients from that initial conversation about their diagnosis to discuss surgery. And then after surgery, when the final pathology confirms this as a diagnosis of DCIS, the potential role of radiation for them based on their preferences and their pathology, and then of course, as you alluded to, the potential role for endocrine therapy. So it's really been fun just in the short time that we've been doing this to see how much better we are now at tailoring the treatment for this diagnosis. So at the Dana-Farber Brigham Cancer Center, we're the only dedicated DCIS program in the Northeast, and research is a critical component of what we do and what we offer to our patients. So we have efforts ongoing trying to better determine which treatments individual patients may need. We're trying to learn from each patient from their tissue and their blood, and then also research around how to make good decisions for DCIS treatment.
Yeah, it's so important because women with DCIS do have so many options, and DCIS is not life-threatening, and so we really want them to be able to understand their options and make their choices in align with their preferences, and helping us to really learn more about DCIS in this process is really important so that we can continue to provide these tailored options for women in the future.
Yeah, so patients who are seen in our program do have the opportunity to discuss research in great detail with their treating team.
Well, when a woman gets a breast cancer diagnosis, whether it's DCIS or otherwise, we know it's a very stressful time. It's stressful for the patient, for the family. And DCIS is particularly, can be particularly challenging because, again, it is stage zero breast cancer, and helping women and their families to understand what that means, to understand that they have curable disease and that we really want to help them work through their options. So coming to a center like Dana-Farber Brigham Cancer Center, where we really specifically focus on DCIS as its own entity, we really spend a lot of time trying to educate our patients and their family members about their options and really helping women to make their choices that are in line with their preferences, understanding that they have those choices. We have a team of specialists from our breast imagers to our pathologists to our surgeons, radiation oncologists, social workers, medical oncologists. We're really all here to help women understand their diagnosis, to help them make the best choices for themselves, and of course, to continue to learn from each patient and advance the research to potentially one day eradicate this problem.
Yeah, so we've put the team together. Where you go first really matters.